Welcome friends, in this tutorial I'm going to go over another method for anime or Toon style shading in Blender, in this case Blender 4.2. And in this video I want to go over a method I found on a YouTube channel called Comfee Mug. They had their procedural setup, so I've gone over other videos of like Goo Engine and their setup, and I don't know if I made a video of it, but there is a V-Roy Studio does anime characters in a different software, and someone made a add-on for Blender to import those characters, and there's a shader in there that I've used a couple of times. But I'm starting to like this method, so I want to go over it. So I would say pause here to go over the videos, and I'll try to put a link in the description for the ones that you need. And then come back here after you watch the videos, because you really need to understand how the shaders work to see the changes that I made. So welcome back. I'm going to show you the changes that I made to the video, and basically why I need to make changes is the method uses a color ramp to define the colors of the object. But what if you had an image texture or you wanted to quickly change the colors of the object? So that's what I'm going to show you here. So I took that node setup and made it into a node group and called it Comfee Toon. Also added it to my asset browser, and you can find tutorials about how to add materials to your asset browser. So that is all this is right here. Before we get into that, I want to say, you saw in the tutorial how you need to basically turn down your sun lamp. So I turned it down from the default of 20 down to 3, and then I changed the angle of the light to 20 degrees. You also notice in the tutorial, if you leave shadows on for your object, so let me turn it back on for shadows, you get these weird shadow artifacts. They're not good for anime, so you need to turn shadow off for every object in your scene for this to work, unless you specifically want shadows for a particular reason. So with that out of the way, let's go tab into our node group to look at the differences. So the main differences here, traditionally in their setup, they have this color ramp feeding directly into this A input on the hue node. And I will reconstruct that. So you see, if I want my main color to be a different color, I'll change that last node over here. For my shadow color is this middle one. So what I did is add two mix nodes in between. You can see right here. And I took the output of the color ramp and made it the factorial of these two mix nodes. I also changed this color right here to white and this one to gray. And so what I do is with this first mix node, the A input is for the shadow color. I'll move this over here temporarily so you can see it easier. So I made my main color B and my shadow color A. So the blue color that you'll see here goes to the B. The red color for my shadow goes to the A. And of course, this node is a mix node. Then I take the output of that, a result, and put that to B here. And this A input is the black color that you'll see on the opposite side of the light. Now you can make this anything you want to, but traditionally, you're going to make it a black color, and that feeds the second mix node. And then that goes to the A input of the hue node. So you can see here, I can change this to anything I want. And same thing with the shadow color. Now you will notice that you don't get an exact matchup with the colors, especially with the shadow color, but I think it's, for most cases, it will work. The other thing you notice here, it does have the outline as described in some of the Comfee Mugs tutorial. So I went ahead and added that outline to my node group, which is basically a Fresnel node with the IOR value set here as an input. I called it outline width. Let me move this over a little bit. And you have a value of 1.2 per their tutorials. So if you want the outline to be thicker, you go up slightly. And if you want it to go away, you set it to a value of 1. And you can't really see it at all. So tabbing back into the node group, you see it feeds a color ramp. And then that becomes the factor in a mixed node mixed with the rest of the node setup into your group output. So that pretty much defines the changes that I made to that wonderful shader. I also applied it to a cube because you can see if I added the convex hole setup for this. Oops, I'm on the wrong object here. Let's go to cube. So I have that same shader applied here, but you won't see much of an outline. And because it works best on curved surfaces and not on straight edges. So you need to use another method, such as the grease pencil outlines or the convex hole method, which I did set up here. So what you would do is add a second material to your object, call it outline, change the base color to black, and maybe take the roughness out of it or turn it all the way up. But the important thing is that you check everything for backface culling, and then add a solidify modifier, and let's turn this back on. The thickness is going to depend on the size of your object and how far away you are from it. So let's just do 0.01 for this. Change the offset from -1 to 1. Make sure you check normals flip. And then your material offset, the number here is going to equal the slot of your outline material. In this case, the Toon shader is slot 0, and then this is slot 1, so you're going to put the number of 1 here. And now you have the outline for your objects with flat edges. So that summarizes the changes that I made, and in the next video, we're going to go over how to apply this to a more complicated character, such as a Daz Studio character from a Genesis 9 model. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.